Hello and welcome to my course on AI automation powered by n8n. In this lesson today, we are going to talk about what is automation and why it actually matters. Well, in the introduction of this course, I told you that we tend to do a lot of things manually sorting emails, manually copying data from one sheet to another sheet, manually posting content on social media. And all this manual work takes a lot of effort from us, takes a lot of time from our lives. But what exactly is the problem with the manual work? The first problem that I see is it's very subjective and prone to human error. We tend to make decisions based on intuition, and at times that produces inconsistent results. The second problem is manual work is slow and time consuming. The repetitive tasks that we keep on doing can be automated so that we can focus on something else, and that task can be done in a faster manner. Third problem is higher resource costs and scalability issues. More work means you need more employees, longer work hours, and bigger budgets. And the fourth problem that comes to it is low employee satisfaction. Nobody likes to do all that repetitive, mundane task each and every day continuously, right? But when you automate things, you eliminate those human errors, you scale effortlessly, and you save more time. But how does automation solve the problem? Well, automation relies on data-driven decisions. The AI solutions or the automated workflow based on logics that you implement in it are totally focused on data which is coming in and the logics that you have put in. No more human intuition is there in the play. Secondly, it boosts productivity as well, because now employees can focus on better tasks which are more creative in nature, which are more productive in nature, rather than those repetitive mundane tasks. Of course, not just productivity, it helps with the employee satisfaction as well. And finally, because it's more like a computer program doing the work instead of a manual human person doing it, you can scale it in an effortless manner. You can buy more compute power, more data power, so less time is wasted, so that means higher efficiency and lower cost. Automation is one secret weapon behind smarter workflows, scalable businesses, and stress-free operations. Let me explain it with a real-world example. Well, if anybody is running business, or if you are running a business, you would be selling things to the customer. The moment you are selling things to the customer is someone who will be onboarded onto your business. You would want to maintain a relationship with the customer, so you would need the details of the customer to be put into some sort of CRM, more like a customer relation management system, or it could be just a file, it could be an Excel, but somebody would be asking the details from the customer and putting the data into your CRM software or some sort of a sheet. And as soon as that data is entered, as a good business, you would like to send a welcome message to the customer so that they get a feeling of belonging next to a business. If you are doing all these things manually, then you would have someone calling into that person, asking for the details. The person or the employee that you have, or yourself, you would be putting that data into your CRM, then sending an email, which is more like a welcome message to the end customer. Now imagine if we put an automation into place, it would be as easy as that. You send a form to the customer, customer fills out that details, and as soon as those details are entered, it goes into a CRM software of your choice or the sheet that you are managing automatically. Then as soon as that data is entered, a job triggers that sends a welcome message to the customer. Here everything is happening with an automation workflow so that you can focus on scaling your business, increasing productivity, and you may not need that employee who is calling in all these customers and asking for details. So that means lesser cost as well. Now that you understand automation is more preferred over manual work, let's define what automation is. Automation is a process of executing predictable set of action based on specific conditions. Think of it like an airport baggage system. As soon as you go to the airport and check in your bag, the system detects it. Then based on the destination that you are traveling to, the conveyor belt is chosen and the bag is put onto it. Then based on certain other logic, the system directs your bag to the right flight. Just like an airport baggage system moves your luggage, the automation helps you move data between different applications based on predefined set of rules. Now that you understand automation, let's talk about what is an automation workflow. Workflow is a term that you're going to hear a lot from me in the entire course, because everything in n8n is a workflow. A workflow is nothing but a structured automation that has following key components. Number one being is a trigger. Trigger is something that starts the automation, that kicks it, that tells it, hey, wake up and start doing something. That's a trigger. Remember our airport baggage example? The moment you checked in your baggage, that was a trigger for the system to detect it and start routing it to the right flight. Now, what could be a trigger in a digital world? Well, an email just arrived in your inbox, a message was sent to you. It could be a WhatsApp message, it could be an SMS, it could be a Discord message, it could be a lead coming into your software system, or a form is submitted, or it could be a time-specific trigger. It could be a scheduled time, 8 a.m. on a Monday. Every day at 5 p.m., something happens, something gets triggered. Every workflow starts with a trigger. It is an event that tells your workflow or automation process to wake up and start doing the job. Second thing is processing, and processing could have different meanings. You can be filtering your data. Only certain set of leads which has email IDs are relevant to me. Rest you are filtering out. Then it could be segmenting data. If a particular condition is true, that data goes to this set of condition. If the particular condition is false, the data goes to that kind of condition. For example, spam emails goes to your spam inbox, whereas your right email comes to, or primary email comes to your primary inbox. You may want to modify or transform data, convert everything into uppercase, convert everything into lowercase, strip off the last name or the first name. Howsoever you might be converting or modifying the data or transforming the data for your end use case. Think of this step as a train station. The data is coming into the train station. It is directed to the right platform where some data processing happens, and the data further continues its journey towards the right destination. And third and the final component is the action. Action is the result of the automation. For example, data being saved into the Google worksheet, data being saved into your CRM software, an email being sent to everyone on the team, or a message being sent to the sales team that a new lead has come in. And relating to the example that we talked earlier in the lesson, a welcome email was sent to the end customer which was newly onboarded into your business. So actions are the result of your automation. They complete the workflow by taking the necessary steps. Now let me share my screen and show you an example of a lead qualification workflow in n8n. And don't worry about n8n, we are going to talk about it. Just let's have a look at how an automation workflow looks like in n8n when executed. So let's say a visitor submits a form on your website. Depending on the details they enter, if the company has information missing in it, the lead is totally ignored. If it is a low value lead, add them to an email sequence from where we will warm up that lead. If it's a high value lead, save them to a Google Sheet. If they match your ideal customer profile, then you should notify the sales team in the Slack instantly so that somebody can reach out to them and try to convert that customer. Now you can see that as soon as I clicked on it, the workflow got triggered. It started processing the data, started executing those predefined set of rules that we just talked about, and then took a final action based on the data that was fed to it. More like the company information was ignored, or the lead was high value lead, low value lead, or if it was my ideal customer, then a notification would have been sent on a Slack channel. Without automation, all this would have been a manual task, which would have been time consuming, because now with just click of a workflow, the entire workflow kicks in, automatically sorts the data, filters the data, and takes the right action without wasting any time. And congratulations, because you have successfully built and tested your first n8n automation workflow. So before we close this chapter, I would like to highlight some of the best practices that you must follow whenever you are implementing any kind of automation workflow or automating any business processes. So the first tip or best practice that you must keep in mind before building any kind of workflow is that you should map out the entire business process or the workflow or the automation that you want to build. And by mapping out, I would like to tell you that you should map out in a flowchart kind of a structure. Use tools like, you know, Miro board or some kind of draw.io so that you map out all the data paths which are there, all the triggers which are there, all the actions that are going to happen. So if you map out all these things, you would be able to place or identify those three key components of our workflow, and it will become very easy for you to implement it. The second tip is you must start small and iterate. As soon as you test a small piece of your entire workflow, test it out. If you are confident, then start expanding into the other areas. So start small, test it out, and refine it. Third best practice is thoroughly test and keep on optimizing it. You must be thoroughly testing your automation workflow before putting into production systems, because the automation might be running on scale. As we talked about, it removes the manual person from the picture so that you can scale. And if there is an error in the workflow, that error will also scale and cause much more damage. Hence, it is very important that you thoroughly test it, optimize it, and make sure there are no edge cases which are remaining. And that's why the second tip that I gave is very important, that you should start small and you keep on iterating or enhancing over it. So that way you will be able to test in small pieces instead of the entire workflow or business process. And fourth and final tip would be that you should monitor and maintain your workflow. Keep on monitoring, looking for the errors. If there are any, catch them quickly, fix them, put them back in place so that errors do not propagate to a larger problem. Similarly, keep a lookout for the settings that you can tweak or the steps that you can optimize so that you can make your workflows more and more efficient. So always remember that a well-defined automation system can save a lot of time, but a wrongly designed one or a poorly designed one with flaws and errors can create havoc or chaos in your business. So always test, always refine, always optimize. That's it for this lesson. Now that you have understood what automation is, why it is so powerful, it's time to get hands-on. In the next lesson of this course, I am going to talk about the overview of n8n and its capability so that you can start building your first workflow from the next lesson itself. So I'll see you in the next lesson.